throughout December, those of us in the virtual Trusted Reviews office have been reminiscing, or I guess slightly not reminiscing, about our best and worst Christmas presents to date. Of course, you know, for every great story about, oh, I finally got that console or that game that I really wanted, there's always a tale of someone who has just completely missed the mark of what you actually wanted, whether it was one of your parents just not picking up on clues, or if it's one of your grandparents who didn't get you the right Pokemon version that you wanted. Let's face it, we've all been there. There's definitely something to talk about this holiday season, and luckily for me, I have a good story. But of course, before I get into that, I just want to say, as always, we'd love to hear from you. If you have any great stories to this effect of best or worst Christmas presents, let us know in the comments below. So let's dive into my story. Now, this will take us back to Christmas 2006, which in hindsight just seems like a completely abstract time. I mean, this was before smartphones, crying out loud. And yet it was also a huge point for my personal history because it was when the Nintendo Wii came out, one of my favorite consoles of all time. And let me tell you now, whatever trouble you think you're having with trying to get a PS5 this Christmas doesn't even compare to how troublesome it was to even look at a Nintendo Wii back in 2006. At this point, it's fairly common knowledge that Nintendo likes to send out minimal amounts of stock just to drive up the hype that's already there. We saw this with Amiibos and quite recently with the Nintendo NES Mini. And as you'll remember, it was so difficult just to try and get your hands on that console. And now it's perfectly fine, but Nintendo did exactly the same thing with the Wii when that first came out. The fact that the console introduced motion sensing into the mix, which at that point was just something the general public hadn't seen at all, and it promised so much more in terms of being able to change what it meant to be gaming in the home. And so everyone wanted one. It seemed to be that if you weren't going to be playing Wii Sports Bowling with the family on Christmas Day, that somehow you'd done something wrong. But I was 14 at the time, and even though I was unbelievably excited to play the Nintendo Wii, I mean, who wasn't at the time, I was old enough to at least rein in the fact that the chances of getting the console on Christmas Day were so minimal that it was best just not to get my hopes up. After all, my dad, who just a couple of years prior had somehow managed to get his hands on a PSP before it even came out in the UK, was visibly struggling to get his hands on a Nintendo Wii. And it was clear that just the sheer amount of shoppers all looking for the same thing was taking its toll. And so I recognized that my time with the Nintendo Wii would probably have to come a little bit later. And it wasn't the end of the world. I mean, I still had the GameCube kicking around at the time, a couple of different games I could dive back into and finally complete. But I'd be lying if I said a part of me just wasn't a bit disappointed, because after all, as people know and gamers know, with any console launch, you want to be there from the get-go. It's the excitement of being one of the first people to get your hands on a brand new console. And oh God, I just wanted to get my hands on the Wii. So on Christmas Day, I started to unwrap my presents and found a copy of Rayman Raving Rabbids for the Wii. And at this point, my parents were quick to jump in and said, look, what we've done is we've gotten you a couple of games now so that at the very least, when we do finally get you a Wii, you'll have some games to play on it. And I figured, fair enough. And by the time I was done opening all of those gifts, there was a nice little collection. Alongside Rayman, there was Tony Hawk's Downhill Jam, and of course, The Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess, which everyone wanted to play. It was the flagship Nintendo Wii launch title. And I mean, looking at these games, I was just so eager to play them, and it was killing me inside, but there was nothing I could do. So I figured, okay, well, let's go back to playing a bit of the GameCube then. But it was at that point that my dad, who had left the room just a moment prior, returned with a Nintendo Wii in his arms, and my tiny little adolescent head just exploded. It's something I will never forget. It's by far one of my best Christmas memories to date and my favorite Christmas present yet. But we'd love to hear from you about some of your best and worst Christmas memories. And we're going to have some more members of the Trusted Reviews crew on here to talk about their own experiences, be they bad or good. And as always, stick with Trusted Reviews for all your tech content.